Welcome to Benidorm.
Very friendly round here.
But I walk round and I say hello to everyone and it's good, man.
Hello.
I like it.
Hello.
The cut-price Mediterranean mecca for bargain-loving Brits wanting a new and cheaper life in the sun.
It's much cheaper than back home, whatever you do. Yeah.
Fry-ups for only a few euro, pizza a euro.
And there are countless ways to restart and reinvent your life, but only if you're willing to graft.
It's easy. If you want a job out here, you'll find one immediately. But you have to want to work. If you don't want to work, they'll just get rid of you.
And with record numbers of sun-worshipping, value-seeking tourists heading to Benidorm...
The main reason he came was for the weather, but I just came for the cheap alcohol, really.
This is my fifth year on holiday in Benidorm. I won't go anywhere else.
Benidorm's got everything anybody wants.
We love Benidorm!
There'll always be bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Coming up, wedding planner Louise is close to a marital meltdown.
Had the bride no aki? No, it's 2 o'clock and we've still got no bride.
Fitness instructor Ant Street Party has an unexpected star appearance.
Really on Benidorm.
And Wayne and Des Bellamy Wright gives a sneak peek at their new swanky pad.
Then we've got the chaise longs for Wayne. Just the right size.
You're getting a bit cheeky, you are.
Benidorm is the Costa capital of fun. Everywhere you look, there are Brits on the beer.
The nightlife, the pubs, all the different bars, that's what brought us here.
And Brits on the Broncos. But one thing that says Benidorm more than anything else, cabaret.
You've got to nearly use your hips as well. If you just use your hands, it's called something else.
I like the comedians. That's what we go see all the time.
I mean, you can get 5 people on in one night, which are really good acts.
Every night, you can watch one of over 50 different acts across the town for the price of a pint. One of the best known was Wayne Wright, a.k.a. Levi G, Queen of the Showboat.
You're welcome aboard this showboat. Hola!
A year ago, Wayne sold the cabaret bar to spend some much-needed time off with his new husband, Des.
You are now husband and husband.
After the wedding, he came back to Benidorm.
Hiya, love.
No business and no job for the first time in his life.
What do you do with all your time now?
Oh, I don't know.
I give you 6 months and you'll be barred.
I will.
You will.
He was. And the lure of the limelight was too much. And today, Wayne's performing 6 nights a week at the Palladium.
The one and only Miss Levi G.
Now, I'm back to where I started in Benidorm, up the main strip. And I've just no stress. It's just so easy. It's a breeze coming into work, you know. It's not really work, is it? It's maybe 18 hours a week compared to 96 hours a week. It's a huge difference, isn't it?
With a new income and lots of spare time, they've been able to buy and do up their new marital home. Think of the future in nearby Lanuthia.
A man's house is his castle.
Until the Queen arrives.
And it was a bargain.
This house, really, it was on the cheaper end of our budget, and we put in a very cheeky offer, and we got it for £160,000, plus the taxes, so that worked out about £190,000, including expenses.
We just love it, doesn't it? Because it's here, we're Wayne and Des, aren't we? And that's it. And
it's a nice piece of tranquility away from the craziness of Benidorm. And we've got the chaise longs for Wayne, just the right size.
You're getting a bit cheeky, you are.
But Wayne's not one for lounging around. He's got a new project.
Come on in.
Along with Tad Dawson and his daughter Paige, they're setting up an official charity to help local vulnerable mothers and their kids.
Now, you're going to have a limp wrist by the end of this because we need 100 signatures. We all need to sign every single page on the bottom here. We're going to be called Busy Bees Benidorm. Tad's a great fundraiser. Des is great organising on the internet with emails and whatnot. Paige is great with her Spanish because she's fluent. So it does need all 4 of us. But of course we'll work it all between us and whatever suits.
But there's obviously only one Queen Bee.
Oh, Wayne's definitely bossy enough to run a charity.
I'm not bossy.
Not so bossy, let's say organised.
I'm a leader.
You're bossy.
All right, well, I don't care even if I'm bossy. As long as I get what I need for my children, I'm happy. If anyone complains, they get deleted.
Sounds pretty bossy to me. All along the 120 miles of the Costa Blanca, British lads and lasses flock for cheap booze and thrills on crazier-than-ever stag and hen nights.
I did see a man in a gimp outfit, though.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Free shots everywhere. Especially for the bride.
But increasingly, they're coming back to tie the knot as well. Hundreds of Brits get married on the soft, sandy beaches of the Med every year. But for one person, it's not all canapés and champagne.
Who would have thought you need a ladder for a wedding?
Meet Louise Bradley. She spotted a gap in the market. Wedding planning and business is booming.
Trusty mallet always comes in useful for naughty people.
A typical week, I would work, I'd say, a minimum of 80 hours. Don't really have any days off between April to probably October, because when you work for yourself, you've got to keep on top of it. Otherwise, they go somewhere else.
Louise left the Midlands for Spain 9 years ago with her window fitter husband, Scott, and two daughters, Lacey and Neve. But long hours working for loved-up couples keeps her away from her own loved ones.
These days are really what the hard work is for. We don't have that many of them, but when we get to see the kids enjoying themselves and having fun with us, it's great.
In an effort to see them more, she ropes them in to help. Chief volunteer, her stepmum.
See, you're busy as usual.
Yes.
This is Irene. She's 74 years young, and she's the best bow tyer in the world, not just the Costa Blanca, but the world. This is Lacey. This is my youngest daughter, and she comes to help with all the weddings in the summer.
I like helping out because I earn money. And also, I like spending time with my mum.
No weddings till she's at least 30. Yeah.
Louise has planned around 400 weddings, but her next is a first for her.
I know Linda's a professional bodybuilder, so she's used to all the show and looking good, so hopefully what we can do is make her look extra special on her wedding day.
And there's something else that's new.
I've been in contact with them for over a year. I've not actually met them, but I've planned their wedding. So it's like, I hope that when they get here, everything that we've planned is what they actually want.
With only 4 days to go, the bride and groom, Linda and Gareth from Northern Ireland, are here to meet Louise.
The main fear is that we don't actually gel, because it's fine talking on the internet, but if you don't actually have a connection with each other, it's hard to work with each other. So that initial meeting is quite important, because at the end of the day, she's put her big day in my hands.
Hiya, how are you?
So lovely to meet you. Nice to meet you.
This is Gareth.
Hello, nice to meet you. First things first, Linda's dress.
Do you want to go in there out the way, just 1 minute? Just in there, because if I open that up and you see it, it's going to spoil it all.
Oh, that's beautiful. Sorry, I love weddings.
I've never met Linda, but never. We must have spoke daily.
Yeah, we have.
For 12 months. So it feels like I really do
know
you.
It does, it does. And it was a big thing for me to hand this over. And, like, if you're speaking to Gareth, he actually couldn't believe that I had handed this over to you.
So I'm privileged then. She's really nice. I do feel like I've known her for, like, years. It's really strange, because when she cuddled me, it was like, you know, got a bit goosebumps. Strange.
It's a good start, but there's still a lot more to agree on. Coming up, new arrivals Paul and Debbie get all giddy with a plan for a chippy.
This is amazing.
We should have done this a long, long time ago.
And Wayne's charity ambition starts with a new wardrobe.
I could look like one of these aging drag queens, couldn't you? You know, goes out in a club in something 10 sizes too small.
In Benidorm, many bargain-loving Brits live on one of the town's dozen or so caravan sites all year round.
It's a totally different way of life. The moment I step into the caravan, I feel a totally different person and can just enjoy life how we should be.
Camping Villamar is the biggest caravan site in Benidorm, with 1,400 plots. This year, they're almost full to capacity, with many new recent arrivals, such as Debbie and Paul Williams.
We moved here just over a year ago.
This is our lovely terrace, patio, if you'd like to say.
Like many expats, they're here for good and made their caravan into their own mini palace, turning the awning into a lounge and kitchen with all the mod cons. All this for...
£10,500. Pounds, not euros.
Made
this is the awning. And then you actually go through to what we've made as our bedroom, dressing room and ensuite.
Home sorted. Now they need an income, and using their savings, they've bought a chippy in the Sun.
Paul used to do fish and chips, but working for other people. So the opportunity of opening a fish and chip shop was absolutely amazing.
After Paul's years away in the Merchant Navy, it's a novelty to be together 24/7.
When we were back in the UK, having separate jobs and Paul working away, it wasn't working very well, but this is just amazing.
And we never have a crossword.
No, we don't. We're happy. Happy, jolly people.
Aw, they set up in nearby fancy Albia, but after a strong start, business takings are down as Benidorm hits its hottest months.
Gone very quiet for us. A lot of our core customer live here all through the winter, and they've gone back. It's too hot for them to stay here.
To up their income, Debbie and Paul have cooked up a plan. Tap into the bargain-loving British caravan community by bringing the chippy to them.
What we've decided to try and up our numbers is to do a delivery service to Villamar.
We don't know how it's going to go, but we are really sort of excited about it.
Despite only using the campsite's social media page, Paul has set an ambitious target for their first day.
If we could do 20 meals, that would be fantastic. You know, next week it could be 40.
Don't get ahead of yourself, Paul. You haven't even got one order in yet. Down the coast in Pilar, there's another Brit business delivering a service to expats on a campsite.
Oggy, oggy, oggy!
Skelmersdale lad Ant is a million miles away from battered fish and dripping fried chips. He runs a dance fitness class on Camping La Monte, known as Ant's Fat Fighters.
When I first started it, it was basically just about getting people who, maybe for 20 or 30 years, hadn't exercised or had done very little. You know, my average client's nearly 70 years of age, and I'm doing something I enjoy. In fact, I'm doing something that I love, and it's also good for them.
Thanks, everyone. Have a lovely, lovely day. I'll see you Wednesday.
But attendance is hit and miss, so today he's working on a new cash-generating project.
And one, two...
A Spice Girls tribute act, made up of himself and four regulars from his classes. Denise, Ukrainian-born Yaroslava, Maria and Jenny.
Ouch, it's hot.
It's hot. It's green. It goes with your dress. The red goes with your eyes.
They're the main attraction of a British street party.
Head up, Jen.
That Ant has organised for 200 paying guests tomorrow.
On the tickets, we broke even, so everything I made has been spent. My money's made tomorrow on the tombola. It's made on the other events through the day.
And again, one.
But for the girls, it's not about money.
Baby Spice is Denise, and as Denise is the only lady who in the last 4 years has actually put weight on rather than lost, we thought we'd take advantage of it and put it in a big pink baby grow. Over the last 4 weeks, Denise has gained confidence. She's learned an actual dance. She still hasn't lost any weight, really, but we're working on that one, aren't we, then? Sporty Spice, also known as Yaroslava, can see your confidence is coming. You know, the very first day we told you we were right Spice across your arse. I've seen the look on your face.
I don't do much in dressing up, that's probably why.
Yeah, no, thank you very much. And, you know, I love all of you, but thank you.
For Posh Spice, Maria, it's more than just friendship and fashion.
I'll tell you what I've done the last couple of weeks has been unbelievable. I'm going to cry in a minute.
When she first came, you were a bit of a loner, weren't you? And Maria in the last month's given up smoking. On our very first rehearsal, Maria couldn't get through it without an inhaler. And now she's doing the routine three or four times over. You're doing great. Thank you.
Aww.
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Because without you, I wouldn't give up smoking. I wouldn't be doing this dancing.
Yeah, well, you've done it. And you're doing it every day.
It's been an even more remarkable journey for Scary Spice Jenny, who's recovering from cancer.
If someone had told me a few months ago that I was doing the Spice Girls, at that time I was in intensive care, a life support machine.
2 years ago, Jen, you were fighting for your life with the cancer and you fought the cancer and you're in remission. And,
yeah, but you sent me wigs when I lost all my hair. You were constantly in contact with me all the time, and it's you that kept me going. I mean that, hand and heart.
Jenny, it isn't about blood, darling. You're our family, and you know that. Thank you, honestly.
Thank you.
I love you dearly. I always will.
There's plenty of love to go around, but it's time this lot need.
And again.
Lots of rehearsal time.
Do you know, my head is coming off its axis. Get ready for your kick. By tomorrow afternoon, I'll be that tired, I'll be lovely to everyone. But for today, if I'm not hard and it's not done, the only person that's going to worry about it in the morning is me. Four and done. But that was brilliant, that girls. Well done. Just have a little minute and then we'll do it again.
Near Benidorm, Wayne and Des have bought a big shop of essentials for a refuge for vulnerable mothers and their kids that their fundraising helps to support.
Today's bill is nearly as tall as me. I think we've spent a total today, just on the essentials, of €1,169. So that should keep us going for about 2 weeks.
Wayne's priority is to make sure all money raised by generous Brits goes to those who need it and not on admin costs.
I watch every penny where it's going because we can't afford to waste it. I won't even allow them carrier bags or, you know, and I won't waste money on paying for delivery. So we have to struggle up this hill with the food, but it keeps me fit, doesn't it?
Hi, Elizabeth, it's awesome.
Hill conquered, they meet up with Elizabeth, who runs the shelter.
Straight through to the storeroom.
Yes, please.
Combined with government money and charity donations like Wayne's, the shelter aims to give vulnerable mothers and kids 12 months to turn their lives around.
Trying to get them back into society and normal life. Normality is it's a basic word here, that they need how to feed themselves, learn how to care for the kids, and also learn that they need to go out back in society and try to get them ready for that. We've got 12 months.
In one of the home's family rooms, the reality of the 12-month maximum stay hits Wayne.
So after 12 months, mother and child both have to leave the unit.
Yes.
That is an outrage. In today's world, it is absolutely outrageous. I'm just disgusted. I never realised that any of our people got put back on the street, and it's just not me sick, actually. I just... because I've got to burst into tears now because I didn't know that.
You know, they need to be heard. And I think that's so important, that work that you're doing, that they see foreigners coming in here with bags of food and drinks, and they just think, oh, somebody is seeing us, you know? We're not invisible, we're not numbers, we're actually people, you know?
Humans are getting ignored.
And being ignored is the last of their worries, with Wayne and Des fully focused on their new passion.
I think our ultimate goal is to make these children normal children.
Yeah.
Well-nourished, fed, educated. That's the most important to us, isn't it?
Today's a big day for wedding planner Louise Bradley. It's time for bodybuilding bride Linda and fiancé Gareth to make their big final decisions.
Guest book? Do you want to use both or just one of them?
Probably the one on the right.
That one?
Your left, yeah.
Yeah.
Glad that's sorted. The average British wedding costs over 20 grand, but Louise can organise a beach wedding for less than five. Even Linda and Gareth's top-of-the-range big day costs half of what they pay at home.
Linda's just paid the final balance for her wedding, so now I'm like a Monopoly banker. They've had lots of extra things like the buffet table and the candy table, a photo booth. There's about 50 people at the wedding and a big setting on the beach, so it's quite a high-budget one. Right.
Linda brought her own dream dress with her. But Louise has plenty for sale if you only want to fly with carry-on.
The dresses that we have in the shop would range anything from €150 to the dearest being €1,500. So we try and keep the prices quite low. This is quite a popular dress. That's one of the dearest ones we've got, and that's €1,500. So still cheap in comparison to back home.
As well as selling dresses, Louise charges a £600 planner's fee and a 10% finder's fee for a host of British suppliers.
How much is that now?
I think I said 120.
120.
Yeah.
Right, so Linda, next weekend.
We're gonna have the two tiers.
Yeah. You're gonna give us any discount?
Well, I have given you my best price, Lou, you know that.
I know, yeah.
Was that what we agreed?
Yeah, £390.
Just one last thing to sort. Hair and beauty through another Louise regular, Geraldine McGough, owner of Head to Toe Salon.
So, what are we doing today?
Thought about like a casual, either like a fishtail.
Yeah.
And then this is kind of...
Oh, that's beautiful.
For you guys can work it out.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
So yeah. Here, clip it in, and then that's to be a sort of centre, because I'm not wearing like necklaces or bracelets or anything.
Can you charge €50?
€50 per person. To go out to a hotel or a villa or whatever.
It's still a lot cheaper than getting married at home or in England, Ireland.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Cheers.
Yeah. Don't get this in Northern Ireland.
Talking of saving money, Louise is never one to say no to a freebie.
Oh, thank you. It's non-alcoholic.
Yeah, right.
I can't wait to do the wedding because now I've met Linda and she's such a lovely person. I feel like I want to give her the best day possible.
We've put our full trust in her and what can go wrong at the end of the day? We're in the sunshine and as long as there's champagne and
family
good.
And friends with us.
We're good. Thank you.
Let's hope. At Gary George's Carousel Bar in Benidorm...
I don't think I've ever been in here, so hope.
Wayne and Des are collecting raffle prizes for an upcoming fundraiser.
Do you want to say what we've got this week, then?
You need a forklift, I think.
As well as essentials for the Women and Children's Refuge.
Tell me we've got some sanitary towels.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Desperate for these, Gary.
The bar is a well-known drop-off point for the British community, who are always up for rallying around for a good cause.
Oh, look at that, boys.
Yep.
Will it fit me? I could look like one of these Asian drag queens, couldn't you? You know, goes out in a club in something 10 sizes too small.
Next collection point, Yorkshire Pride 3 and Tad.
We managed to beg and borrow and get
some stuff. I've got a few boxes downstairs for us.
Oh, brilliant.
I've got to go inside market and see Vicky.
Oh,
she's giving us wash and blow.
Well, that's no good to me.
I use wash and go and it went.
In Tad's cellar, there's a hoard of kids' gifts. It's very welcome, but sadly, they need checking.
I think they've got some with best intentions, but like you say, you don't know what's in them.
Yeah.
One we sent is it for kids, and it was a sex toy.
Ooh.
We can't risk anything getting to the kids without us opening it and checking it. And oh, that's really cute as well, isn't it?
Nice beat, Tad.
I'm getting excited.
I'll show you who the butch one is here. This is why I'm so thin, because I get all the heavy stuff. Sad for them two buggers. Gonna open a Weight Watchers. Old Queen coming through.
After a slump in sales, Albia chippy owners Paul and Debbie are on a drive to bring in more customers with a new delivery service. Despite it being 32 degrees, they've got their first order.
What would you like? Cod? Chips? Any peas? What's the plot number? Right, now we've got home delivery. So one cod, chips and mushy for around 5 o'clock this evening.
OK.
Thank you.
There we go.
I mean, this is pretty amazing. We've only been in the shop 10 minutes. And already we've got an order.
So two cod, chips. Any peas with those? We've got mushy peas or garden. OK. Thank you. Our place in the sun, good evening.
Wow, they're flying in.
So I'll see you just after 5, then.
Very excited. I mean, you know, that's 3 orders straight away, first afternoon. Long may it continue.
I've got 2 large cod chips. I'll see you probably in about 15 minutes.
Forget paella and tapas, the bargain Brits are missing their chips.
Whoa! This is amazing! Woo! All excited.
It's normally just a trickle of tickets, so having 4 tickets up there and 2 there waiting is perfect. We should have done this a long, long time ago.
It's quite exciting. It's our first delivery, but there shouldn't be any problems. I know the site.
Yeah.
Let's go. Oh, I need a key. Paul?
Yeah?
Car key.
Yeah, they'd probably help. 5 minutes later, and Debbie arrives at Villamar.
Here we are. I love fish and chips, and it's too hot to cook them, so I thought I'd give them a go. Thank you very much.
Change.
And thank you very much.
Thank you. Come to me, have you? Plot 2433.
No, 2432.
Close enough, eh, Debbie? Best to double check the order.
It's 2 large cod chips.
That's it.
It's €20.90, please.
So far, so good. But coming up, there are delivery disasters.
You've taken one to the wrong place.
Ah?
Who?
Dress dilemmas.
So the dress might not fit.
The dress might not fit.
And doppelgangers.
Maria.
What?
You look like Tim Healy on Benidorm.
You got a voice like that.
On the outskirts of Benidorm, it's the first day of deliveries for Paul and Debbie Williams' chippy. Their new scheme started well with a rush of orders, but Debbie has returned from her first delivery to some bad news.
You've taken one to the wrong place.
Don't worry then, Deb. This one...
Well, she told me her sister had placed the order and it wasn't 3-3, it was 3-4.
But then she phoned and she said, well, I'll have this then for half past
six.
Well,
that's 2-4-3-2.
Teething problems, and you didn't take your phone with you. Because we tried to phone you.
So I still need a delivery for 2-4-3-3.
Turns out two Brits facing each other both fancied a chippy tea. Huh, what are the odds?
I think in future we need to take phone numbers.
Yeah.
That'd do it, but it means one customer is without their fish and chips.
That could be him now.
3-3. Well, somebody came out of the caravan and said, oh, no, it's not 3-3, it's 3-4, so I've given it to them. So I do apologise and it will be back with you as soon as we can get it cooked. All goes very quiet when you're concentrating, doesn't it?
OK, have you got it right this time, Debbie? Sure?
I've got my phone this time.
Good.
All right, any problems, give me a call.
So it's back to Villamar and the scene of the chip confusion once more.
I am delivering this order to 2-4-3-3. I'm not going to listen to anybody. It's going to plot 2-4-3-3. Hey, so, this is yours.
Yep.
And we've got 20 euros 90. Well, how do you feel about this service?
As long as the neighbours don't steal your order.
Fantastic. Enjoy.
No bother.
Thank you.
I mean, I don't think we could have dreamed that it was going to be as successful as this.
Just on day one, in the first hour and a half of it starting, it's been fantastic. There's been a little hiccup, but we've rectified it.
I mean, this has got to be almost 15 extra meals that we would have done on top of our normal day. I think we might have a celebration for the weekend.
At the Palladium Bar in Benidorm, there's another pair hoping they'll be celebrating later today. Wayne and Des have arrived at the big fundraiser. With an ambitious target of 20 grand for the Women and Children's Refuge, they need a full house.
Now, listen, €3, right? Hopefully, we should get at least 300 people in, and it's nearly full already, so, yeah, it's going to be a good turnout. It'll be rammed in an hour. And you'll get some down this arm, that arm, the other. Yeah, I don't care, it's a charity day. Everybody pays, right? No exception.
Inside, buckets are being filled with cash.
Thank you very much.
Donations are coming in.
About 500 euros in there.
What?
And with money raised on social media, they're starting with a healthy running total.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for coming and supporting us. We've already raised 6,877 euros.
While the free entertainment gets everyone in a good mood to part with their cash...
The fabulous Miss Jill Ryan!
Cheers, everybody!
What they really need is their chief fundraiser. Where's Tad?
So I've just been out collecting a few quid and I've managed to get 7,114. That's what I've just collected today.
That's quite a few quid.
How are we doing, me old star?
Oh, look at that cocker.
Wait till you see what I've got.
It's been a great pleasure. My day off today, and if I can help somebody else, I'll help somebody else.
Get in here!
And when you see them kids' faces, it's brilliant. That's what it's all about.
We've found him, and we've got some good news for you.
I've just fetched quite a little bit of money.
The money's been donated mostly by the Brits of Benidorm, who've got deep pockets when it comes to a good cause.
Yorkshire Pride 3 last night, did karaoke, raised 64 quid. And Tad put 2 grand in.
We have a grand total up to now, ladies and gentlemen, of 16,981 euros!
We need 20,000 today, that was our target. So dig deep, I'm coming round to get you!
Better get your wallet out. Down the coast from Benidorm in Torrevieja, wedding planner Louise Bradley is getting ready for bodybuilding bride Linda's wedding.
When I wake up on the morning of a wedding, I feel quite nervous, and in this wedding more so. because we've got Linda's wedding dress. So if we forget it, there's no wedding.
There's another big issue with the dress.
It's going to be quite hard to get her in the dress just because she's so broad and athletic. I think that's going to probably take an hour.
An hour?
This is definitely the first bodybuilding bride that we've had, so it'll be nice, be different, and she's lovely.
To help her on the day, Louise has roped in stepmum Irene again.
She must be the fittest 74-year-old on the Costa Blanca. She has to be, because she has to do all the running around. I can point my finger like a council supervisor. You do this while I do this.
Right, what do we need for a wedding? Decorations? Check. Bags of sweets? Check. And sword, eh?
The sword's used for naughty grooms. When they play up, we can smack them around the ear hole or to cut the cake, normally.
Sword safely stowed, it's time to head to the venue. Everything is unpacked and the team begins to arrive.
These are our photographers for the day. I found the hairdresser, but it's 2 o'clock and we've still got no bride.
With the beach booked from 6 till 7, Linda needs to hurry up, but 15 minutes later, she's still not arrived.
Are the bride no aquí? No.
Exactly. She's definitely no aquí. Another Brit with a big stressful day ahead is Lancashire lad Ant. His best of British street party at Camping Le Monte is about to begin.
It's all right. Getting there, we've got about an hour till we start, but about 20 minutes till people will start arriving, because that's what they do. Like to get there a bit early. And I've still got no makeup on.
As the guests start to arrive, Ant goes into meet and greet mode.
Good afternoon, everybody. Is everyone okay? Oggy, oggy, oggy!
Oi, oi, oi. I'm sorry. But there's a real feeling of good old British camaraderie at the street party.
It's going to be absolutely fabulous. Everyone's moved in and can't wait for the Spice Girls. It's going to be a brilliant day.
Yes, highlight of the day is a performance by the Spice Girls. Well, Ant's girls, anyway. And at the moment, they're outside their A-lister Winnebago, the makeup lady's motorhome. Better look sharp, girls. Ant and his sidekick Lily are en route for an inspection.
And I can't wait till we get up here to the home of the Spice Girls. Girls, spice up your life!
Hello, Lily! You look like I'm in drag.
Apologies to the makeup artist, but you look like Danny LaRue.
And the fifth member has arrived. Cue Ginger Spice.
Yay! Wow!
That was about as exciting as a cup of PG decaf. I look nice in a frock, though, don't I?
You look better than a woman.
Bet you'd love to fit in a pillowcase.
Sporty Yaroslava is practising her moves.
There you go. A little bit of bling goes everywhere, doesn't it?
Quick zhuzh for Baby Spice, Denise.
And then head off. Look at that. Gorgeous. You look fabulous. Absolutely fabulous. I'm not sure Emma Bunton would agree, but you look fabulous. Posh, go and get dressed. Chop, chop.
Scary Jenny's looking a bit scary. Best leave her be. Posh Spice Maria's ready, though.
Maria.
What?
You look like Tim Healy on Benidorm.
I know what
you like. Tim Healy? Hey, girls, doesn't she look like Tim Healy on Benidorm?
I've got a voice like that.
Come on, Leslie.
No one recognised me, thank God.
I'm not even thinking about climbing on that podium. I'm just going to get on and do it and smile and try and remember what we're supposed to do and have a good time. Enjoy it.
Good time, Skelly!
Wow!
Now I'm getting excited.
She's not the only one.
Oh, are you ready to put your dress on like your mum?
Good girl, get a kiss. No.
Scary gets a few last-minute tweaks.
I turn that down a bit. You look a bit like Brian May. That's better.
And it's nearly time to hit the stage.
I think the crowd that's in today is going to go absolutely mad. So, are you ready, girls? You've got 3 minutes to get to the stage, OK? Nice and slow, though, nice and slow. I just hope that they pull it off, and I've got every faith that they will.
It's almost time to spice up the party. Back at the wedding venue, the other star attractions of the day, Linda and Gareth, have finally arrived.
We've got a bride! Yay! We thought you'd change your mind.
Shall we get some more rays on the beach?
Have you been at the beach?
Yeah.
Really? So you thought, right, the morning of my wedding, I'm going to go to the beach, relax, make everybody panic that I'm not coming, we're going. It's gone past 2 o'clock. She's not come. She's changed her mind. No, we're fine. We're not bothered now. You're here.
It's all good.
She's relaxed. She's been to the beach on the morning of her wedding, so I won't be doing that. But she obviously trusts me to get it right.
Elsewhere, everything is going to plan. Tables are set, cake has arrived, and on the beach, the outdoor ceremony is taking shape.
Sent Irene down here to make sure the chairs are put out, the chair covers and the bows. And if you've seen Irene, she's quite bronze, like a mahogany colour. So I always send her out to the sun because she likes the sun, but then she's nearly dead at the end of it. Irene's quite particular about her bows because she thinks she's the best, but she's actually not.
I think it's maybe because I'm left-handed. Or maybe I've been tying bows since I was 5.
Irene, can I ask why being left-handed makes you better at tying a bow than a right-handed person?
Well, you're right-handed and I tie better bows than you, Louise.
Touché.
Shall we have a bow off?
No cheating.
How can you cheat making a bow?
You might look how I do mine.
I'm concentrating.
That's mine.
You see what hers looks like.
Hey, no cheating.
I'll take all day. I'll be ready for 5.
What do you reckon?
It's better than your normal.
Suppose it's a compliment. Back upstairs, it's wedding dress time, but there may be an issue.
Because we've been here in the sun and drinking alcohol and eating nice things.
So the dress might not fit.
The dress might not fit. We're not really built for wedding dresses in my sport, but okay, we'll give it a whirl.
It's the marital moment of truth.
Try and relax your arms, because if we can get that, what can I? Fastened.
Thanks, it's lovely.
It's good, I'm not losing
any. Please don't move just yet, because it's only held on by an open eye.
Coming up at Ant Street Party, it's showtime.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Spice Girls.
And Wayne reveals the final total.
We've got a check.
In Guadama, just down the coast from Benidorm, it's the big moment for bride and groom Linda and Gareth and wedding planner Louise.
They're going to do the kiss in a minute.
It gives me great pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Yay! About time we can relax.
But there's still plenty of work left to do.
One job I get to do a lot is when they're having the photos to hold the drinks, which is a nightmare because I don't want to hold it. I've been here all day. I want to drink it.
There's just one last job before Louise can have a well-deserved beer of her own.
Linda, your hand's on the bottom. So this is the last time you're going to have your hands on top of hers because she's always going to be in charge from now on.
Everything went so smoothly. There was no stress whatsoever.
Yeah, it's been an awesome day and we couldn't have done it without her.
It's been a great day. And for me, seeing the bride and groom happy, and I've had lots of cuddles and hugs from them to say thank you, and that's the most important thing is when they say thank you. That's all you can ask for.
Well, apart from getting paid, obviously. One big showpiece done, it's time for another at the Best of British Street Party. Let's hear it for the main attraction.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Spice Girls!
I have never seen the Spice Girls like that before in my life. Weren't they fantastic?
It was great. I'm so proud of them. Without my girls, I couldn't have pulled the day off. And for that, I'd always be eternally grateful to them. They were wonderful.
What an experience. It's been fantastic. I felt proud to be a part of it, actually.
When people start cheering you on, it gives you that extra adrenaline.
And I thoroughly enjoyed it.
I've never done anything like this before, and it was just, I was so scared, really, really scared, but hey, we've done it! And I loved it.
For Jenny, the day was particularly poignant.
I never thought in a million years I'd be actually on a stage in front of
100-odd people in a leotard and a wig. I was used to the wigs because when my hair fell out, but it's just something that will always be in my heart. It's fantastic. Never, ever forget it.
Well done, girls. Come on.
Ant organised the event to raise some cash towards his rent money. So was it a financial success?
My initial aim was to raise about €500. I didn't quite make that much and I probably made half of it, but the money's not important to me. What was important was everyone having a nice day and everyone enjoying themselves. So to me, that's my job done. Do you want to do it again?
Yeah! And it's inspired him to think even bigger in the future.
My nan brought us up that the world's your lobster, and if you don't try and explore that world a bit, you're going to turn into a crab. So for me, I'm going to take the lobster and I'm going to try and invade a bit of the world. I can't wait to see what's going to happen next.
Back in Benidorm, there's more money raising going on. Yeah, even Meatloaf has turned up to help.
We've got a check.
This is a boss.
Oh, it's from you, €500.
After 4 hours of fundraising and collecting for the Women's and Kids Refuge, are they close to the 20 grand target?
We're on 19,431. Wow.
So close. But with Tad on the rampage, it won't be long, surely.
Well, as you can see, we're going out with football card. There's 40 teams. €2 a go, the winner gets €20. And we've just drawn it now, Northampton, which is PJ. So I'm just going round now to see who wants it. And then I'll look right sad, and then they'll chuck it in bucket.
Good plan.
PJ Northampton. PJ Northampton. I don't know who it is. Nobody claims it's sold, it's going straight in potty.
Hard luck, PJ. So the day's almost over. Has it been a success?
Grand total up to now, 19,931.
Well, I can make that to 20.
Wow.
210, 215.
Wow. Oh, that is just amazing. There's not a charity in this town ever raised that kind of money on one fundraiser, is there? And we should have enough money now for essential food and goods to see us through till Christmas.
All the expats come together when it's something desperate as what we do. Everybody comes together.
So it's time to reveal the final total.
Ladies and gentlemen, up to now, and we've still got some little bits to count, we've got €20,146!
Next time on Bargain-Loving Brits in the Sun, new skippers sailing the showboat.
That's made me feel all tearful. I brought lumps in my throat.
Did you really get any sand, Gary?
Not as much.
Campsite garden glitz from these two Bargain Brits.
It would look lovely if I put a chandelier here.
And it's dog rescue time for a British animal charity.
Because she was thrown out of a car, we haven't got a clue how old she is.